We used to be told if you're HIV positive, you're not supposed to give birth. That is why they sterilized us.
The nurse asked me how many children I had. I told her that I had two, and she told me that this pregnancy should be my last because I was HIV positive.
I gave birth to twins, attended a postnatal clinic that was providing mothers living with HIV with free medicine and baby formula. The attending nurse told me that if I did not get on family planning, I would not be given my share of milk. What family planning method? I asked. She responded by saying, tubal ligation. I was shocked.
The day after I delivered my baby, the nurse came around for her usual rounds. I was in a lot of pain. That's when the nurse told me that it was because I was recovering from two surgical procedures, a cesarean section and a tubal ligation. I was in great shock.
When I went into labor, I was immediately prepared to go to the operating room. Little did I know they intended to conduct tubal ligation as they were delivering my baby. As I was being wheeled into the room, they quickly gave me some papers to sign. I thought I was simply consenting to the cesarean section.
Imagine being given a piece of paper and you're told to sign so that you get family planning. You wouldn't know what it is. I came to learn that the tubal ligation I signed for was permanent when I joined a support group for HIV-positive women. That's when I discovered that I could not give birth.
This judgment is significant for women living with HIV because for a very long time, cases that were filed in South Africa, cases that were filed in Namibia, and elsewhere have had the difficulty of making the link between the tubal ligation and the HIV status of women. It has reaffirmed the fact that it is wrong, it is against the right of women living with HIV to subject them to tubal ligation solely on the basis of their HIV status.
This brought a lot of problems in my home. My husband asked me why I didn't tell him. He started drinking heavily until he was hit by a car and he died.
My husband left. He left me when our child was a little over a month old.
MSF, we never did, and we are not doing medical sterilization in our missions in Kenya. So, in case if the patient opt for to undergo bilateral tubal ligation, we normally refer them to third party facilities to have it done there. So, our part is counseling them properly, informing them properly about the possibilities. We acknowledge the part of the responsibility, our share of the responsibility for what has happened to the women. And we want to restate, as a medical organization, our commitment to the patient-informed consent process and to the patient dignity in general.
Whether or not you're living with HIV, you have a right to as many children as you wish. No one has a right to decide a family planning method for you, and every method should be clearly explained to everyone, the advantages and the disadvantages.
The reason we filed this case was to fight for the rights of the younger generation. I would not wish my fate on any young girl who is living with HIV.